I am Lester Van Moody. I am the GSU Student Senate President. As is GSU tradition, we will welcome our freshman class in just a minute. But first, please help me welcome our dual degree program students and congratulate them on the completion of their associate's degree at the community colleges. Our sophomore, junior, and senior classes, along with grad students, will be led into the auditorium by the Gonfalon Carriers, who are members of the GSU Student Senate. Angel Jackson for the class of 2021, Jasmine Gardner for the class of 2020, and CeCe Singleton, a senior GSU, the class of 2019. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the students of GSU. A GSU tradition is to give new freshmen a GSU cords, cords they will wear 4 years down the road at the commencement ceremony. Cording this year's freshmen will be David Gollin, the Faculty Senate President, and our Excellence Award winners from last year, Associate Professor Delania Comer-Hagen, Associate Professor Natalie Irma Hoven, and Chair of the Division of Arts and Letters, Jason Zinkshine. And now, just as you made me feel at home when I was a student and as a freshman, will you join me in cheering on and welcoming our new freshmen, the class of 2022. Everybody, please be seated. All right. Frank Bruni, a columnist for the New York Times, recently wrote an article, How to Get the Most Out of College. Now, don't worry, I'm not going to give you a long list of do's and don'ts, but I'm going to pass along something he wrote I think is very important. He said the wisest students move into a peer relationship with a university rather than a consumer relationship. I urge you today to have a real relationship with GSU. Just don't go to class and call it a day, but get involved. I would like to introduce to you some involved students. With the members of our Student Senate and any student leaders of GSU Club and or organizations, please stand up. You may be seated. Now look for these students on campus and join them in participating in the club or organization. Frank Bruni also wrote that we are in college to widen the circle of human beings who know you and actually care about you. What did I say? I widened my circle. And I widened my circle when I came to GSU, and it helped me in so many ways. And since I'm quoting people today, let's hear some college advice from former First Lady Michelle Obama, with a little bit of me thrown in there as well. Number one, don't waste time worrying about what others or whether you belong in college, because you do. Put that energy into working hard and learning as much as you can. And number two, don't be afraid to try new things. This campus is full of new things to try. Former First Lady Obama also agreed with Bruni. She says, whatever you do, don't try to do this thing alone. Look for your support group and be open when someone comes looking for you. Now, I must confess, I'm not looking forward to the stress caused by long nights of studying in front of me, nor the papers, nor tests, but I welcome them all. It means that I am getting an education, and that is not easy, but we all know it's all worth it. So welcome or welcome back to GSU, and we are glad that you are here. Now, earlier I mentioned about student groups. So we're about to showcase one of them now. So please join me in welcoming the Transformation Gospel Choir.
Students. My name is Leah Booker. I am the current president of the Transformation Gospel Choir. Today we will be performing an a cappella arrangement of the song Seasons of Love, arranged by our secretary Jasmine Garner from the musical Rent. Remember the love. Remember the love, remember the love, measuring love, seasons of do, 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 do,
525,600 minutes. How do you measure? Measure a year.
In daylights, in sunsets, in midnights, in cups of coffee.
In
riches in miles and laughter and strife.
In 525,600 minutes, how do you measure a year in the life? How about love? How about love? How about love? Measuring love, seasons of love, seasons of love,
in truths that she learned, or in times that she cried, in bridges she burned, or the way that she died.
It's a new thing, though the story never ends.
Let's celebrate, remember the year in the life of friends.
Remember the love. Remember the love. Remember the love. Measuring love. Seasons of
Thank you to the Transformation Gospel Choir for that song of encouragement. Now, I am pleased to introduce to you the GSU President, Dr. Elaine Maiman.
Well, thank you, Lester. And let's give our Student Senate President a round of applause. I have to say that planning this convocation was so much in the students' leadership, and I hope you enjoy it because they really rethought what we do. And so it's the best convocation, at least so far, that I've ever participated in. And Seasons of Love, the GSU Seasons of Love. This is our first season as we welcome all of you. And what a thrill it was to see our dual degree program students, our graduate students, and all four undergraduate classes marching into the auditorium. It's just a wonderful to see you all here. And it is my honor hereby, officially, to declare the opening of the 2018-19 academic year. And as I enter my 12th academic year as your president, I am pleased to report that Governor State University is moving forward toward our 50th anniversary with a spirit of innovation and continuity. I want to acknowledge trustees in the audience. I see Linda Coleman, our student trustee. Are there any other trustees in the audience? Well, let's give a round of applause for Linda. And let's also thank all those who planned this event and the social hour that will follow. Arena Food Services, Digital Learning and Media Design, the staff of the Center for Performing Arts, our events guru, Karen Caesar Smith, Penny Perdue, and the Convocation Planning Committee, so much led by students, and Van Moody. So let's applaud them. Now, our first order of business in the program is to announce the three Faculty Excellence Awards. These awards carry substantial cash prizes. Never enough, though, because the faculty deserves even more, I must tell you. But these awards are $6,000 each. And each recipient, and many of you may want careers as faculty members, so keep that in mind. Each recipient is a true exemplar. Many thanks to the Excellence Awards Committee, chaired by Jason Zungsheim. I'd like all members of the committee to stand and be recognized. Now, there aren't many secrets on university campuses, as I think you will soon find out, but we try to keep this a secret. The winners will not know that they've been selected until their names are read. This year, I will be joined on stage by students who will announce the winners and then explain why they won. To our winners, as your name is called, please come to the stage at my right. Your names will be called in alphabetical order, and the students will be quoting from the Excellence Awards Committee's decision letters and nominations. So, first off, please join me in welcoming GSU Student Senate President Lester Van Moody back to the podium to announce our first winner.
This year's first Excellence Award winner is Dr. Shuxin Ji. Dr. Ji is a professor of finance in the College of Business. Her nominators talk about her consistent high standards in teaching, research, and service. One stated that she serves as a model of excellence and professional responsibility. As a teacher, her students give her high marks. She is tough but fair, responds quickly to those with questions or difficulties, and make challenging finance topics interesting for her students. Dr. G is a productive researcher, publishing and presenting at a number of conferences each year. She also serves on the editorial board of several publications. Those of you who are familiar with the Google Scholar, this will be especially interesting to know that her work has been cited over 1,200 times. Her service to the university is impressive. Dr. G co-chaired the committee charged with revising the MBA program, and we all know that GSU now carries the AACSB accreditation. She is, or has been, a member of the University Curriculum Committee, Faculty Senate, and is the faculty representative to the Board of Trustees Human Resources Committee. These are just a few examples of Dr. G's contributions to GSU and her work to her students. For these and to other accomplishments, we are happy to present Dr. Shuxin Ji with this year's Excellence Award.
It's so wonderful to hear the biographies of our faculty. We're so proud of our faculty. And special congratulations to Dr. G, and let's give her another round of applause. I now invite GSU student Timothy Kappos, a junior majoring in communication, to the podium to announce our second winner.
Good afternoon, everyone. Our second Excellence Award winner is Dr. Laura Stache. Dr. Stache was nominated as a leader in teaching and research, as well as a steward of the GSU mission for an inclusive and diverse environment with high academic standards. She's an assistant professor in communication studies and the program coordinator for gender and sexuality studies. She teaches a wide variety of classes, from freshman students taking her first year seminar to graduate students taking courses in their master's program. Over the summer, I had an online course with Dr. Stache, and I was impressed with her as an instructor. She was very attentive and punctual with her replies. She was also very supportive of my educational growth. Dr. Stache encouraged me to seek an internship and provided me with the information that explained the value of graduate school. Students comment on her love of teaching and say that she breaks things down so that everyone can understand the lessons being taught. She's a well-respected mentor of students and a supervisor of internships. Perhaps Dr. Stache's most interesting research resulted in her book, Breaking Bad, A Cultural History, which was published last year. Library Journal called it a stunning dissection of the critically acclaimed AMC TV series. It was well-researched, yet also a fun read. She further serves the university through her work on the Graduate Council and the Intellectual Life Committee. In her field, she's a member of the National Communication Association, and she is also a reviewer for the Journal of American Culture. I am proud to present the Excellent Award to Professor Laura Stache.
I always learn so much, a book on Breaking Bad. I just told Laura I have to read that. I want to get a copy right away. And I hope that the students are listening to these interesting nomination remarks, because it's what our faculty will bring to you. And so I think it's good for you to have this kind of preview of our excellent faculty, and let's again congratulate Dr. Stache. To announce our final Excellence Award winner, please welcome student Shannon Payne. Shannon is a grad student currently in her last year of internship in the School Counseling Master's Program.
Good afternoon, everyone. Our third Excellence Award winner is Dr. Catherine Atkins-Wicks. Dr. Atkins-Wicks is an assistant professor of school counseling in the College of Education. Nominators describe her as an exemplary professor and counseling professional who is trustworthy and generous colleague, and a stellar leader. Combining both service and research, Dr. Atkins-Wicks was invited to create a task force to write and set of competencies for mental health counselors to work with military populations and veterans. The first of its kind. She is passionate about her work and holds a long list of positions on service organizations and associations. Just one example is her board membership on the Military and Government Counseling Association. Her research is collaborative. She has co-authored articles, grants, and book chapters. Students appreciate being included in her research projects and are able to co-present at conferences. Her students also appreciate her dedication to their studies. According to a nominator, she fosters class environments that are supportive, inclusive, and collaborative. A student described Dr. Atkins-Wicks as someone whose unwavering support and dedication for her students is unparalleled. And I can equivocally speak to that. I first learned about the SDS scholarship from Dr. Atkins-Wicks in the fall of 2016. As I am now entering in my third year of the school counseling program and my fourth semester with the support of the SDS scholarship, I consider myself very much a benefactor to Dr. Atkins-Wicks' advocacy and encouragement. I am proud to present this Excellence Award to Dr. Katherine Atkins-Wicks.
Students, I hope you heard that Dr. Atkins-Wicks told our student introducer about scholarship opportunities. Please be sure to stay in close mentoring touch with our wonderful faculty. They're going to be able to help you in so many ways. Let's again congratulate Dr. Atkins-Wicks and all three of our Faculty Excellence Awardees. And I'm proud to say we have many more at home like them. You're going to really, really get a wonderful education working with our great faculty. Now, we turn to the Basor Award. The Basor Award is presented in memory of Dr. Gerald C. Basor, Associate Vice President of Academic Affairs, who for 18 years served GSU with distinction. The Basor Award is the highest honor GSU can bestow on an employee and is presented each year to the individual who has demonstrated the qualities that Dr. Basor exemplified. Absolute integrity, total competence, generous dedication, unfailing civility. I want to thank the campus community for the wonderful letters with inspiring details about the qualifications of your colleagues. This award is so important that we present it only when we have the strongest possible nominations. And this year, did we ever, the committee really struggled. Our winner was among a field of very strong candidates, and it was not an easy decision. All right, so now, I'm going to tell you who the winner is, and I'm going to give you some clues first. Now, the people who have been here longer than our new students will begin to pick up the clues. The Basor winner is, quotation, caring, honest, loyal, and always cheerful. Well, that eliminates a few people right there, right? There we go. We just eliminated 50% of the possibilities. She always goes one step beyond the expected and continued to be a terrific mentor to any number of GSU students who've worked under her guidance and supervision. Mentoring students is so important that I know that many of our faculty and staff are great mentors. Even if they're not labeled as such, you're going to find students that they're going to help you. All right, back to our Basor winner. She is willing to help any person with any problem, whether it is as small as a lost necklace or as large as, now I'm going to give a great big hint, or as large as diffusing situations involving ticket and performance issues. Ladies and gentlemen, this year's Basor winner is Patricia Guy, box office manager. So Patricia, come over and stand by me. And you may not all have heard, Patricia Guy is the box office manager at the Center for Performing Arts.
Yeah!
All right, now I'm going to embarrass Patricia, and while she's standing here, say a few more things about her. I can attest that Pat's customer service skills are excellent. One nominator wrote, "Pat has provided professional and exceptional customer service to each and every patron who visits GSU's beautiful venue," and you're in it right now, and it is beautiful. But this award is not just about doing your job and doing it well. It's going above and beyond, persevering, working with integrity, thinking beyond yourself, and helping others to feel connected to what we do. Pat does all these things with grace, humility, and kindness. Pat's influence is felt past the CPA. She has served on GSU's emergency response team, keeping us safe. She's one of our campus community campaign leaders, helping to raise funds for scholarships. And she serves an essential role in something that's very close to my heart, and that's the Center for the Performing Arts and Education Program. You see all those school buses lined up? You're gonna see them, new students. And those buses bring 34,000 school children every year to see their first live performance here at the CPA. Some of you may have been among those. Anybody here come to see a play at CPA when you were in elementary school? Yay, great. Oh, wonderful tradition. So, let us congratulate Pat one more time. Okay, so we're going to ask all the winners after the ceremony to please meet me in the green room and we'll take some more pictures. And I'm sure, you know, don't worry, I'm sure that people will save some ice cream for us. It won't all be gone when we get out there. Now, Lester Van, as we call him, gave you some inspiring tips from Michelle Obama, but he left one for me. Never forget, there are so many people who believe in you. Look around this auditorium, students. GSU faculty and staff are here because we believe in you. Your success is our success. We believe in what you can accomplish. Two more pieces of advice. First of all, please remember it shows strength to ask for help. That some people think, oh, gee, I'll look weak if I ask for help. No, it shows strength to ask for help. And there are lots of people who are standing ready to help you. And most important, and it seems simple, go to class. of success in life depends on showing up. So be sure you show up. Now, everyone, it's time to enjoy ice cream. Welcome to the new academic year.
They wish and I wish and I wish and I wish and they wish and on me. Yeah. I've been moving calm, don't start no trouble with me. Trying to keep it peaceful is a struggle for me. Don't pull up at 6 a.m. to cuddle with me. You know how I like it when you loving on me. I don't wanna die for them to miss me.